Because scan isn't an interesting serial primitive, it's a little bit harder to find a real-life example. The best example I know is balancing your checkbook, which was useful back in the Paleolithic days when people still wrote checks to each other. So let's take a look at an example. When you manually balanced your checkbook, you had a list of transactions, and you usually had a couple columns in your checkbook. The first column has your transactions, your deposits and withdrawals. The second column has your account balance, the cumulative sum of all the transactions so far. So let's do this as an example. We start off with nothing in our bank, and our first deposit is $20. So our bank balance is now $20. We add another five. Then we make three withdrawals. Draw $11, withdraw nine more dollars, withdraw $3 more, leaving us with $2 in our bank account, add in another 15, and so on. Now, the input to scan is this column of transactions, and the output of scan is like your bank balance. What you can see is that at any given time, your balance is the cumulative sum of all the transactions that you've seen so far. Scan here is calculating a running sum of its input. That's a perfectly cromulent way to think about scan. So now let's turn to the mathematical description.